Duchenne muscular dystrophy, or DMD, is a progressive muscle disease. From the standpoint of clinical care, parental counseling, and patient counseling, it can be helpful to divide the disease course into multiple stages. We know that baby boys born with DMD do not have normal muscle or normal motor development, but findings can be subtle or undetectable early on. The Bayley 3 scale is known to show lower scores for infants and young children with DMD, and can be helpful in the very early stages of disease. Oftentimes, boys with DMD will have some delay in motor milestones, particularly in walking. The average age of independent walking in DMD is about 18 months, but there is considerable variability. Some boys walk on time, others may not walk until they are 2 years old. Speech is often delayed as well. In early childhood, boys typically make developmental gains but lag behind their same-age peers on things like climbing stairs or standing up from the floor. We may begin to see a Gower's maneuver when patients try to stand from a low position and must push off one or both knees to get to an upright position. As boys get older, towards ages 5, 6, or 7, their muscle weakness becomes more evident. They will struggle more to stand from the floor. A Gower's maneuver may become more apparent, reflecting the proximal weakness in their hips. Their gait may take on a more waddling characteristic due to weakness of the hip extensor muscles. Toe walking, caused largely by the contracture of the Achilles tendons and the calf muscles, becomes more evident. This is about the age at which lumbar lordosis, or sway back, becomes more obvious. From ages 7, 8, or 9 years, we start to see the late ambulatory stage of DMD. Walking becomes increasingly difficult. The child may require a scooter or some assistance, especially when navigating longer distances, such as in a store, a mall, or a zoo. Boys may also experience increasing muscle pain with vigorous or prolonged physical activity. Most boys with DMD will lose independent ambulation around age 11, 12, or 13. Steroid treatment has helped push that time out by a few years. When independent ambulation eventually is lost, patients will require a manual wheelchair or power chair for mobility. At this early non-ambulatory stage, upper extremity function is still largely preserved. However, over the next several years, boys will begin to struggle with upper extremity function and certain activities of daily living. As patients move into the late non-ambulatory stage, during the mid to late teenage years, upper extremity function declines even further. Patients may even struggle with distal movements, such as finger and foot movements. The ability to self-feed, along with other activities of daily living, may be lost. In addition, we begin to see a decline in cardiopulmonary function. In general, by the early 20s, patients with DMD have lost all functional upper extremity movement and become entirely dependent on a caregiver. The current lifespan of boys with DMD, at least in the United States, is estimated at between 25 and 30 years of age. There are certainly patients who are living beyond that, and improved care, especially care to preserve cardiopulmonary function, has been largely responsible for their increased lifespan.